हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई मिस पूजा कलंगे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आईआई सेमर एमसीए, वेलकम यू टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर द सब्जेक्ट बिग डेटा एनालिटिक्स। टुडे वी विल बी कवरिंग चैप्टर 3 ऑफ आवर बिग डेटा एनालिटिक्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन। द एजेंडा फॉर टुडे इज वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज बिग डेटा वेयरहाउस इन एनालिटिक्स। आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट आर द बिग डेटा वेयरहाउस सिस्टम रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड व्हाट आर द हाइब्रिड आर्किटेक्चर। Then we are going to see what is the enterprise ecosystem, and then we will see big data and master data management. This is one of the important subjects which is being in the big data analytics, and so you try to pay attention while I'm telling this. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so typically if you see, data management follows a well-governed, or you can say a well-organized process. Means for any business requirement, we have some metrics, we have some KPIs, we have some data reports or some data sources which are being fixed. So you can see here in this figure, as it says, it tells you the process which is being followed in big data analytics. So what we use in this case is we try to have the integration module which helps to have the data which is coming from the CRM, which is coming from the ERP, which is coming from the finance, then which is coming from the sales and marketing. So what we will do here is we will first do the data profiling. After we do the data profiling, then we'll try to find out the data quality analysis. Why we'll do the data quality analysis is we want to check the correctness and completeness of the data. Then we will develop some, you can say, as the analysis oriented data models. Like we have the, as you can see here, the traditional EDW, that is enterprise data warehousing, and dependent data marts, which will help us to keep the data in a proper analysis, which will be made through some data models. And after that, we will develop some reporting and analysis applications. Okay, so that could be, you know, this could be the reports, whatever the reports you have, whatever the dashboards you have, or whatever the multidimensional cubes which are being used. And finally, after this, what we will do is we will develop the analytics module. We will churn the models. We will see the customer segmentation models. We will see the pricing models, and then we will try to have the cycle. So if you just compare this data, big data, with the analytics process, is that here you have the data which is coming from the CRM, ERP modules, okay? And after that, what do you do is, after this, you just have this data into the ETL extraction, transforming, loading process, which is a part of the data warehousing. After that, you try to sort the data structure which is being brought out into the traditional enterprise data warehousing, or your dependent data mart, which has already been a part of, you can say, as the data warehousing. And then this data is being, you know, analyzed by the enterprise data warehousing or the BI administrator. And in between, there will be some data analyst or some business analyst who will be helping out in this, okay? And then this will be useful to the users, that are the BI portals and the BI users. So if you consider a traditional data processing lifecycle, what it could be like. Now, if you consider nowadays, there has been an influence of web, there has been influence of mobile and other devices, right? So this has actually challenged the traditional approach of how the business processes have been working. Why? Because due to the changing nature of data. If you see now, data is no longer centralized, or it is not limited to one enterprise. It has been distributed everywhere. So highly distributed, you can say it is polystructured. Polystructured, in case you can say, it is a composition of structured, unstructured and semi-structured data, right? So in that case, what you have to do is if you just consider the last two decades, okay? So the traditional enterprises data warehouse are not able to cope up with the business requirement, or you can see as the data is be growing at an exponential rate. So what we have to do in this case is this big data analytics, it is going to play a very important role. But what important things is explained in that is the implementation styles, what implementation styles you require, what technologies will be adopted. So these are a very different big data scenarios, right? So what we have to do to leverage this big data, we will have to develop an enterprise data ecosystem or a platform ecosystem, which will help us to utilize this traditional enterprise data warehousing or the dependent data warehouse. As well, it will help us in using the big data information, okay? So this will finally give us a combination of the hybrid data warehouse architectures, okay? And that such system, you can say that such ecosystem will be said as a BDW, that is big data warehouse. So I hope you are clear with this point of big data and analytics, how these both are being merged or being combined with each other. So we will be meeting in our next video lecture, where we'll be comparing the comparative view of the big data warehouse and the enterprise data warehouse design principles. What are their characteristics and the properties associated with that? So I thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.